Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Hanna Virkki, and I have worked at GTK for 25 years now. My expertise has been mostly related to spatial data and spatial data products. And this data management is technically a little bit out of my work at assignment, but I try manage. Also, my camera maybe will turn off because of browser connection, but don't mind. So I will be now sharing my screen. My presentation topic is a geological data management and solution. Shorter synonym for that is geoinformation system. Here you can see the generalized diagram of our geoinformation system. It is divided in two parts. The orange is the intranet for inside use, and the blue one is the extranet services outside of organization. I will show an example of couple from each component. It just can be a picture of the content, a software, or a service. Our present geoinformation system is quite old, at least 20 years. So we are starting this year an extend project to redesign, reform, modernize our system, update the whole package in following years. But this presentation is still based on the current old states. The ArcSD, the database, is a base storage place for our spatial data. All the geological data, which are under continuous updating process, is stored there by different teams. The database structure contains spatial data sets, separate tables, and relations between those two. Then there is a separate database called RIHI for non-spatial information. For example, our mineral deposit database, METCA, or isotope data of bedrock is this kind of information. In the future, the old databases is migrated to PostgreSQL and PostGIS database format. And the storing place is maybe Azure Cloud, at least for products. And of course, some kind of hybrid model is possible for time being, because ArcSD spatial database is so it's a foundation for many internal processes and solutions. It takes time to recode those applications over PostgreSQL database. And overall, the new solutions are maybe different to what we have used. Quite a lot of data is stored in distributed file system or directories also. The basic principle to this kind of storing system is that if the data don't need any updating at all, the file storing place is enough and permanent. The second principle is that temporary saving, the data is saved there for time being to wait until the database solution is ready for importing the data to the real database. Our distributed file system is divided into three parts. Pohjadata, base data in English, is for base maps and the background data of other organizations. Of course, we try to access datasets from other organizations through interfaces as much as possible. But in some cases, the data is also stored in our directories too. Geodata is for geological data, which don't need any update process, but there is need for permanent saving. The data is classified into rasters and vectors, and it can be everything from scanned data to file databases, from observation forms to separate finished but need to be saved project data. Master files are the files where all the adding and updating is done by a few people, and the updated content is copied to Pohjadata and Geodata files with only reading rights for inside house use. The product server is a separate file directory under master file for published data, which will copy to outside the organization for use by services. The future plan is that we have to go through all these files and contents, clean up the duplicates and unnecessary information, reorganize and so on. The file system will be renewed. Then a few words about the interface applications between geologists and databases. This application is done for updatable data. One of the main used interface applications is Haavi, a net in English. It is a custom coded application for data extracting from the main database and importing back to the main database. When importing back, the quality control is done at the same time. The check-out and check-in procedure is for bedrock and profile point of superficial deposit and pit observation and drill holes. Makesi is used to transferring basic ground geophysics and petrophysics to databases. It means about bedrock sample and drill core measurements, for example. And the index of ground geophysical survey will be updated automatically for the geologist. Metso is a user interface software for maintaining the mineral deposit database. The database contains information about all mineral deposits in Finland. And this mineral deposit database is based also on global standards and related vocabularies. There is a team behind this who will update the data whenever that new data become available. And of course, in future, all the application will be recoded for ArcGIS Pro or partly replaced with FMS server APIs. ArcGIS Desktop is one of the basic softwares to use daily, and we have last update to version 10.8.2 in autumn. We have built on top of ArcGIS Desktop several custom tools for data storing and extracting, and there is quite a lot of to check before those are ready for updated version. Furthermore, ArcGIS Pro can be installed if geologists want, but there is no custom tools built on top of it yet. Here are some examples of custom tools, which functionality is largely based on ArcMaps tools. With Maapeli, geologist saves observation of the stratum data for superficial deposits. The observation can be a test pit, drilling, roping point, sections, and so on. Geochemistry side is included too. Kapalo is made for bedrock surveying, like observation point, tectonic measurements, structures, textures, and so on. Both of these, Maapeli and Kapalo, mobile apps are available, but unfortunately, I don't have any pictures about those. All information about bedrock drilling is saved with Kaira Lokkeri. There is also a Kaisu software where the drilling is planned and hole ID is reserved first. Turso is for peat survey. The collected information is Meyer type, peat reserves, peat physical properties, and so on. There is also a Tuppo software for peat profile drawing. Then we have solutions where only extracting is possible. The data is extracted by selected area or selected points. And extracted data is only used as background data for scientific purposes, or for example, delivered manually to customer. The Magella software is used to extract an aerogeophysical and ground geophysical data from the database. Then there is a RAPI, rajapinta. It is used to extract the drill hole data, like logging and analysis from the database. The extracted data is transformed to access and Excel formats, which are easy to use in modeling software. And this is very popular database to deliver to customer also. Of course, in the future, all these softwares have to recode for ArcGIS Pro system. And a little bit usability will be improved if needed. But the database structures don't change, or minor changes are done in future. Then we have a GIS data menu. It is a custom tool for adding the data easy to the map view. The content of the menu has expanded over the years. The geologists have been very happy with the extension because they don't waste working time for looking the data in different storing places. The base maps and other background data than geology has been collected in its own separate menu for quick adding to map view. GIS VASU represents a newer technology that replaces the beloved GIS data menu. GIS VASU is a GIS portal based on S3 technology, which contains the same data as in old menu. The materials can be opened or downloaded and used on both ArcGIS Desktop or ArcGIS Pro. Then a few words about the productization. The productization is a process where we modify the raw data to the spatial data products for the customers. Productization ensures that all the minimum information is found for distribution, and the data is processed and checked with data stewards. The data is collected from internal Oracle and file systems. The work and data manipulation is done mainly with FMA Desktop, and quite new investment is FMA Server, which will help change the processes towards automatization. The complete spatial data product is transferred into external Oracle and downloadable zip files to the file server. A product database compiles all the minimum product information for use of the Hakku service mainly. The product can be a report, publication, on old map drawing, or a spatial data. Here is just an example picture of product database's user interface from spatial data side. Information to be filled out includes a name, an abstract, a license level, product picture, distribution channels, price, metadata file, and downloadable zip file name. Added information will be saved to the product database tables which Hakku service is reading. If you remember how our internal complex Oracle content look like, the external database is more harmonized by the layer name and the content. Most of the layers are gone through this productization process where the data is simplified, cleaned, and the data structure and content is more customer friendly if possible. Our services, map services, and interfaces reach the spatial data mainly from here. Here is just an example picture of our file server content. The publication reports, old maps, and old observation worms are collected here for Hakku service to fetch. Also, the zip files of the spatial data are copied here for downloading. Of course, the future visions is to add more automatization for updating the spatial products with FM server. Our web map service and web feature service are published to ArcGIS server. Those are standard interfaces which are grouped by data team. The data of these interfaces are free of charge and there is no need for create any account. Maaperä is for all kinds of superficial deposit data. Kallioperä is for bedrock data team. Geofysiikka is for geophysics. Kivian Svarannot is for bedrock aggregate and aggregate sand and gravel data. And Pohjatutkimukset is for ground investigation, which contains data outside of organization, for example, from Finnish Transport Agency. There are plans at least part of these ArcGIS services are replaced with GeoServer in future. They already published few services with GeoServer, for example, One Geology interfaces. The last section is about services. Perhaps our most used service is the Hakku service, which compiles huge amount of data together for searching and downloading. There is a different sections for publications, reports, maps and posters, photos, old map drawings and spatial data products. Majority of the data is free of charge, but there is also purchasable products. Mineral deposit and exploration map service is designed especially for mineral exploration purposes. It includes information on mineral deposits and mines, extent exploration data, permit areas, and nature conservation areas. Maakamara is our most used map service. It is for general use and point of view is more superficial. All the basic geological data is presented there. Lähde, Spring in English, is focusing to groundwater survey and provides access to classifluvial deposit modeling data. Pohjatutkimukset ground investigation is a service for viewing and downloading data on ground investigations. The most data is collected collected from Finnish Transport Agency. Then the last service. The layman sample practice is a unique Finnish practice that aims in finding, researching and increasing the information of national raw material resources. Hobbyists can send a samples of ore, industrial minerals, industrial stone, natural stone, gemstones, and so on to geologists. And a promising sample can lead to a whole new mining or rock industry operation, which benefits all the society. On top of this is built Omakivi, my own stone in English, a mobile app, and a web service for saving powder, boulder, and bedrock observations electronically. And after that, it is possible to send samples to layman sampler office. These were only a couple examples of map view services, but maybe most used anyway. Because of historical reasons, we have done for different purposes a wide selection of map services. And in future, it is time to renew those one by one, and it is more than possible that we combine those services so that maintaining would be easier. This was my last slide and a quick and quite generalized view to our geoinformation system, but I hope that it gave some general idea of our geodata management and solutions in GTK.
Right, thank you, Hanna. Do we have any questions? There we go.
Thank you, Edward Buckland from NFIT. I had a question like this, that you showed that you have this internal or external data set, but probably you have also the Inspire data set. How have you integrated this data set? It is in your system or it is a separate, and how does it work? And the other question is also, you told all are this charge-free or open data, or you have also restricted data or data for selling or something. Thank you.
I hear my own voice. the second question, this restricted data, we don't have so many restricted data. All the data are public. And when we sell the data, we have two license levels. There is an open license and this restricted one. And when we deliver the restricted one data, it is for only the inside of organization use. And the customer have to sign the agreement for using that data. And what is the first question? It is about Inspire data. Inspire. Do you mean Inspire?
Okay, thank you. Any other questions for Hanna? Seeing no hands being raised at the moment, then thank you very much, Hanna.